Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see a very tricky question, which is: given two numbers, how to find the XOR between these two numbers without using the XOR operator? So let us understand the problem. Let us assume that we have been given two numbers, which is X and it is 3, and Y which is 5. Okay, so if we represent this in binary, then it will be 011 and 5 in binary will be 101. So what will be the XOR between these two numbers? If we find the XOR between these two numbers, then it will be 011. That means 100. This is the XOR between 3 and 5. Now how can you find this XOR without using the XOR operator? One simple solution is, write these numbers 011, which is X, and Y is 101. Now what you need to do is, you will check the elements bitwise. So suppose you are checking the first bit and you need to check whether both the elements are same. That means if both are 1 or if both are 0. If both are 1, then you will write here 0. And if both are 0, then 0. Otherwise, if they are different, okay, then if they are different, then you will write here 1. Similarly, when you go to the second bit and you check it, then you can find that they are different, and so you will write 1. Similarly, you will write here 1. So this is a very simple solution. We will see the efficient solution at the last. Let us see the code for that solution. If we assume that the X and Y are 32 bits numbers, that means X is 3, which is 32 bit, and Y is 5, which is also 32 bit number. Then 3 can be represented by using 32 bits, 0 followed by 0, 0, 0s, and then finally we will have 1, 1. Okay. So this is the representation for 3, and for 5 it will be 101, last 3 bits, and all these are 0. Okay. So what this is doing is, it is checking from the most significant bit. This code will be checking from the most significant bit. It will check whether the given bit, that means whether the current bit is set or not. We are starting from the 31st bit and we will go till the 0th bit, that means from left to right. If the current bit is set in X, then it will be true, then B1 will be true. If the current bit is set in Y, then this B2 will be true. Now we are saving the current bit, that means the resulting bit, the XOR bit, by using this condition. If both the bits are set, that means if B1 and B2 is 1, then we will store 0. Otherwise, if both the bits are not set, then what can be the combinations? Either X can be 0 and Y can have 1, either X can have 1 or Y can have 0, or both can have 0 and 0. Okay, therefore in these three conditions we will just OR, bitwise OR B1 with B2. Therefore if 01 occurs, then it will be 1. If 10 occurs, then it will be 1. And if 00 occurs, then it will be 0, because bitwise OR of 0 and 0 will be 0. So this will be stored in our XOR bit and we will have a result. Result will be initially equals to 0. We will left shift the result by 1 bit and then we will bitwise OR this result with the XOR bit. Okay, and these were the XOR bits, this one. So this is a simple solution, but it is not the most efficient solution. Let us look at the most efficient solution now. The efficient solution is to find negation of X, find negation of Y, and then do bitwise OR between them. Okay, once you do this, you already have X and you already have Y. You do bitwise OR between them and then you do AND operation between the results of these two. This will give you the XOR between X and Y. So let us understand this. Let us write X as 011, which is 3, Y with 101, which is 5. Now negation of X will be 100 and negation of Y will be 010. Okay, when you do bitwise OR of X and Y, then it will be 1 1 and 1, and if you do bitwise OR of negation of X and negation of Y, then it will be 011. Okay, once you have found both this, then what you will do is, you will do just bitwise AND. When you do bitwise AND, it will be 110. So this will be the result. That means if you do X XOR Y, then the result will be 110, and this can be done in just a single line. So this is the efficient approach in order to find the XOR between two numbers without using the XOR operator. I hope you were able to understand this video. If you have any type of confusion, then please comment below and I will try to help you as soon as possible. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of these programming videos. See you in our next video. Thank you.